The most anticipated and extraordinary Starship mission, the Flight 12 marks the maiden test of the V3 Starship, a variant equipped with significant enhancements aimed at achieving long-term success. However, it is also crucial for this flight to produce results quickly to maintain the program's momentum, making this launch one of the most crucial in Starship's history. As always, SpaceX and Elon Musk have planned meticulously, maintaining secrecy while working on what could mark a major advance in reusable rockets and exploration beyond our planet. So what preparations has SpaceX made for this mission, and what factors will influence its success? Let's discuss it all in today's NR Studio episode. In the Starship development timeline on the 12th flight, marking the first momentum booster of the highly anticipated V3, this mission is expected to be very different from previous tests we have seen. The uniqueness of the 12th flight comes not from SpaceX's launch technique, but from the various new components and systems that will be integrated into the process. Since this is the maiden flight of the V3 model, the mission outline will generally retain familiar aspects. The rocket will ascend, move into the upper atmosphere, and separate into two distinct stages. The Super Heavy booster will eventually return and attempt a controlled descent, likely culminating in a soft landing in the ocean. Simultaneously, the Starship upper stage will enter orbit, release its payload, conduct further demonstrations in space, re-enter Earth's atmosphere, and aim for a controlled landing. Essentially, the flight strategy will replicate much of the protocol from the recent V2 mission, but will not attempt to overrun either stage. This tactic allows SpaceX to safely test the new iteration before undertaking the more complex retrieval operation. However, the true excitement and specialness of this flight comes from the innovations themselves. These improvements are at the heart of a secretive initiative Musk and SpaceX have devised to advance Starship toward full operational readiness. Let's start with the most visible change, the launch site. For the first time, Starship will lift off from Pad 2 at Starbase, an entirely new launch area never before used. The sight of SpaceX's colossal rocket ascending from a six-legged platform featuring a water deluge system will be a thing of the past. Instead, this launch marked the debut on a revamped runway with a box-shaped OLM supported by a dual flame trench configuration. This upgrade signifies significant improvements in reliability and reusability. The updated stand is anticipated to offer improved structural integrity during takeoff, while the dual flame trenches beneath it will help divert exhaust gases away from the vehicle, thus protecting the runway from intense heat and pressure. These modifications are intended for the long term, as it is anticipated that Starship's launch power and frequency will increase significantly in the coming years. By expanding the current launch pad design, SpaceX has made various improvements to its ground systems. The suction cubs used on Pad 2 have been shortened and strengthened to better support Starship V3. Their primary function during Flight 12 is expected to consist of lifting and securing the spacecraft during the stacking process. However, in future missions, they will be essential for capturing the boosters and returning spacecraft. Below the surface, SpaceX has made substantial revisions to the fuel tanks and transfer system. It remains uncertain whether the company will rely on a dedicated smaller system positioned near Pad 2 or connect it to the more extensive system located on Pad 1. However, recent pump replacements and fuel line upgrades indicate that SpaceX is enhancing its fueling capabilities to accommodate the increased propellant demands of the new vehicle. Starship V3 features slightly larger tanks and an advanced fuel transfer system to accommodate the Raptor 3 engines, which require more efficient fuel flow. Furthermore, the water deluge system has been reconfigured to align with the new fire bucket layout. Because the water flow required by the twin fire buckets is higher than the previous steel plate cooling mechanism used on Pad 1, SpaceX had to install higher capacity pumps and larger storage tanks to ensure adequate cooling during liftoff. All of these systems will be evaluated during Flight 12, marking it as a vital test for Starbase's long-term operations. Now, let's turn to the rocket itself, where the most substantial modifications can be found. The highlight of these improvements is the new Raptor 3 engines, which will power both stages of Starship for the first time. With 33 Raptor 3 engines firing at launch, the boosters will produce more than 9,000 tons of thrust, exceeding 2.7 times the power of NASA's Saturn V rocket. This level of thrust will make Flight 12 one of the most impressive launches ever recorded. However, the Raptor 3 isn't just focused on power. It has been completely re-engineered to improve reliability and efficiency. The engines feature fewer components, streamlined piping, and an improved ignition system, all contributing to reduced operational risk and reduced maintenance time. SpaceX has highlighted that this new design also improves manufacturing efficiency, facilitating production scaling and easier replacement. During the 12 flights, these engines will be closely monitored. Their performance will impact whether SpaceX can progress toward future goals such as payload delivery, orbital refueling, and ultimately mid-air capture of both stages. Any significant engine issues could delay that progress. Therefore, reliability will be a key aspect of this assessment. After liftoff, Starship will undergo ascent and enter an enhanced hot staging phase.
In contrast to the previous V2 missions, where the hot staging ring existed as a standalone component situated between the two stages, the updated design incorporates the system directly at the top of the booster. As a result, the hot staging mechanism is now integrated into the first stage itself, which streamlines assembly and minimizes pre-launch tasks. When the upper stage ignites, the attach ring will detach smoothly from the booster, which helps to reduce debris and enhances operational efficiency. In fact, the hot staging segment is no longer thrown away, as its weight has decreased significantly compared to the former configuration, a change easily observable to the naked eye. The redesigned structure is more straightforward and efficient, facilitating improved heat and pressure management during the separation phase. This advancement not only boosts efficiency, but also enhances the overall resilience of the system. Consequently, the revamped hot staging design is expected to be crucial in SpaceX and Musk's covert strategy for Flight 12. Although it still remains a prototype feature, the probability of its success is anticipated to surpass that of the engines. During the descent of the booster, another important enhancement will be introduced: the grid fins. These elements have experienced major changes in terms of design, quantity, placement, dimensions, and weight. These modifications aim to enhance aerodynamic control and extend the grid fins' long-term lifespan. The new grid fins will function in conjunction with the engines to provide stability and steering of the booster during its return, while also aiding in a more gradual deceleration process. Significantly, these improved fins will integrate catching points within their design, representing a pivotal move towards SpaceX's ultimate aim of capturing and reusing the entire booster. Flight 12 will act as a preliminary test for this integrated system, assessing how effectively the fins perform in both navigation and catching capabilities. Meanwhile, the upper stage of Starship, referred to simply as the ship, will pursue its mission outside Earth's atmosphere. One of its primary goals will be the deployment of payloads. Although specifics are scarce, the V3 version of the dispenser is anticipated to feature various enhancements, which will enable the system to manage and deploy actual payloads more efficiently than in the past. This advancement signifies a step closer to fully operational missions, in which Starship will eventually transport satellites and cargo into orbit. Additionally, the ship will conduct a relight test of its engines in space, demonstrating the abilities of the newly designed Raptor version 3. These engines are intended to provide enhanced performance and greater reliability, even under the extreme conditions found in space. Nonetheless, arguably the most vital upgrade for the ship is its heat shield. Although SpaceX has not disclosed comprehensive information, it is believed that the heat shield for Starship V3 signifies one of the most extensive redesigns to date.
Improvements are expected to include improved tile materials, more reliable installation techniques, improved placement, and enhanced cooling mechanisms. These modifications are designed to avoid issues encountered in previous missions, including tile loss, cracks, or leaks. The redesigned system is expected to offer better protection for the spacecraft during re-entry, particularly against extreme heat and oxidation. Particular attention has been paid to the heat-shielding tiles located on the rear flap. This area has traditionally been one of the most vulnerable parts of a spacecraft, often facing high temperatures and mechanical stress during descent. Reinforcing this area will be crucial to ensuring stability and enabling the spacecraft to navigate effectively in the atmosphere. By addressing these issues, SpaceX can improve the safety and accuracy of re-entry, paving the way for improved recovery techniques in future missions. Similar to the improvements made to the ground systems and Super Heavy thrusters, the modifications applied to the spacecraft are still in the experimental stage. However, it is expected that they will function reliably enough to facilitate future achievements. For example, the new payload ejection mechanism must operate correctly to demonstrate readiness for commercial operations, while the heat shield must function flawlessly to enable safe and consistent returns. Both of these improvements are crucial to achieving SpaceX's ambitious goal of achieving two-stage capture and full spacecraft reusability. If successful, Flight 12 could mark a significant milestone in Starship's development. Each improvement, from the heat staging system to the grid fins and heat shield, will contribute to creating a fully reusable and highly effective launch system. So, which advancements are you most excited about? Share your thoughts in the comments and be sure to follow every aspect of Flight 12 closely, as this test could reshape the possibilities of space exploration. SpaceX currently faces a significant workload to make Flight 12 a reality. If the mission is scheduled to launch before the end of the year, the preparation time is less than 2 months, which is a very tight deadline, even by SpaceX's ambitious goals. Currently, the rocket and launch facilities are still incomplete, the spacecraft is still under assembly, and installation of the new launch pad has not yet been completed. As a result, a series of critical tests, including cryogenic tests, tank pressure evaluations, and static fire trials, have not yet begun. To keep everything on schedule, the SpaceX crew needs to accelerate progress on all the systems involved. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next time.